Here at Holy Cross, we have a clinic called the Cardiac Resynchronization Therapy Clinic. It's part of the Advanced Cardiac Therapeutics Clinic that we run for patients with advanced heart failure. For these patients who have implanted devices, these are devices that are called biventricular ICDs. These are devices that try to make the heart beat in a more synchronized fashion. So the ideal patients who come to this clinic are patients who have currently implanted biventricular ICDs. These are the ICD systems that have wires both in the right ventricle and the left ventricle. If you don't know what type of ICD system you have, simply ask your cardiologist. These are patients who have these devices and are still experiencing symptoms of shortness of breath and are taking good medical therapy. These are the patients that come to us and say, "Hey doc, is there anything more you can do with my device in terms of making me feel less short of breath?" And we try to bring them into the cardiac resynchronization clinic and see if we can further optimize their device through a multimodality team-based approach where we look at the patient's heart pump function under echocardiogram, we make adjustments to the way the heart contracts, and then we measure these adjustments to see if it helps the heart squeeze and beat a little bit more vigorously. The ultimate goal will be to help these patients improve their symptoms of shortness of breath and be able to get a little bit more quality of life. The CRT clinic has been around now for approximately 1.5 years. We run it once a quarter for patients who are identified as being non-responders to CRT pacing therapy. And the clinic has had a good success where patients come in and get approximately 45 minutes to an hour of one-on-one care with the physician and other team members who are caring for this patient. Frequently, we'll find that patients either have device settings that can be optimized or tweaked on their behalf. Sometimes we'll find that there's a problem with the wires which would necessitate a procedure to fix the wires. And rarely we might find that there's arrhythmias that could be causing the patient's reasons for shortness of breath and not having the optimal settings on his device, and therefore we would recommend an ablation for the arrhythmia. All of the above things are potential reasons why somebody could be a non-responder to their CRT device, and that's why we have this clinic available for our patients.